Hello, I'm here. Yes, I am wearing the same outfit. I film more than one video in a day so I can just post them throughout the week because why? Why do I need to bother changing my shirt if I'm just in the same, it's the same day, I don't care. If you have a problem with me wearing the same shirt in two videos, that's your problem. Toodaloo. So today I am here with another writing video. I thought I would do the writer life tag. I saw a few other writers on YouTube doing this video and so I thought I would do it. So I'm tagging myself, okay? So there are 10 questions and I'm just gonna get right up into it. Write fuel, what do you eat or drink while writing? So I can't eat while I'm writing because then I get too distracted by the food and I can't focus on what I'm writing, so I have to eat before I even start writing. If I drink anything, it's water or it's tea, but most often it's water. Write sounds. What do you listen to while writing? So sometimes I don't listen to anything. I'll just have to be quiet. That's what I've been doing more lately because I focus better in the quiet sometimes, especially when I'm like kind of struggling a bit more with getting the words on the page. But if I'm feeling more into it, I like to listen to alternative music, like alternative rock. I like to link some of my favorite songs at the end of my video, so, you know, just check those out. Write vice, biggest distraction. The biggest distraction is my own mind, I think, because, like, I'm an introvert, I'm in my head a lot, and so sometimes I'll think about random things that have nothing to do with my story. My mind will just go off on a tangent in that, and that leads to the internet. So the internet is usually only a problem, though, when I'm not really into the writing, but when I'm really into it, I don't really get distracted a whole lot. So, yeah, and sometimes I get distracted by thinking about what I'm doing. You know, if I'm doing it mindlessly, if I'm just like blazing out those words, then it's fine. But once I start thinking about the fact that I'm blazing out those words, then I start, it kind of gets a bit meta. Like I'm thinking about what I'm doing and it makes me sort of self-conscious in a way. It's really weird. Write horror. What's the worst thing that's ever happened to you while writing? The worst thing. I don't know. If I really have to pee and I can't wait for the end of the paragraph or the end of the sentence. I just have to go like right now. Which, you know, if I'm drinking tea especially, because I drink it a bit more quickly than I drink water, then, you know, that bladder, like that. So, I don't know if that's really a horror though. It's kind of just like another distraction. I could say my biggest writing fear, which is not what the question is asking, but my biggest writing fear, of course, is losing all of my work some way, so there's that. I guess if my computer, so you know how sometimes Microsoft Word starts acting up and like it'll not respond, or you try to save it but it doesn't want to save because the internet's not connecting even though the internet is connecting, and so you have to like restart the program. You might lose your work because you weren't able to save it, so there's that. I guess I'm afraid of that, the internet glitching out. Write joy. What's the best thing that's ever happened while writing, and how do you celebrate small victories? I probably don't celebrate victories in the way that I should, because like in my previous video where I was wearing the same shirt, I talked about how I don't really have a willpower, and so I'll just reward myself for not doing anything. Like, I'll go down and I will eat that pastry even though I didn't write, you know, however many words that would probably be worth writing to earn that pastry. So, I guess the best thing that ever happens to me while writing is if I'm just really, really focused and I'm able to crank out, like, a lot of words, if I'm able to write a lot of scenes, and if I love those words, which, you know, if I'm really into it, I usually do love the words that I write, so there's that. Write crew. Who do you communicate with or not communicate with while writing? So I don't communicate with anybody while I'm writing because I like to just do it solitarily, if that's a word. I do have a couple of friends who also write, so and every now and then I might talk to them about something, but I don't really communicate with anybody while I'm writing. Except for my characters, I guess. Does that count? Write secret. What's your writing secret to success or biggest writing flaw? My biggest writing flaw, I guess, is that I'm very easily distracted, like, very easily. Like, that dog from Up, I'm almost just like, if I see something moving out the window, I'm like, squirrel, or car, or whatever. Yeah, there's a window right here, so if you see me, like, looking down, that's because there's a window right there. And I can see every car that's driving in and out of the neighborhood. Writing secrets to success. I think something that really helps me most of the time, but is not currently helping me right now, is the way that I plot. On a scale of 1 to 5, 1 being like a complete pantser and 5 being a complete plotter, I would probably say I'm about a 4. I like to have general plot points, but I like to, you know, kind of get to them how I want to get to them, and if I need to change them along the way, then I'll give myself the freedom to do that. So I guess that's probably what it is, because that allows me to be really creative, but also it helps me to know where I'm going. Because if I give myself complete freedom, then I'm just lost in the dark without a flashlight. Writing inspiration. What makes you productive? So I had this theory probably like a year ago where if I'm feeling kind of down or depressed about my writing productivity, like if I'm just feeling not creative, that it could be solved by taking a shower and listening to my favorite music and just kind of like singing out loud in the shower. Doing that is like really, it's almost like a fresh start, like a recharge, you know? And then after that, I'm just like, if I'm thinking about my writing as well, then I start to get really excited about writing. Yeah, I haven't been able to do this lately, so I should probably try it soon. But just music in general. It doesn't really matter if it relates to my story or not. If I'm just really enjoying it, then that'll usually just inspire me to write. Other things that inspire me are probably other forms of media, like reading. A lot of times when I'm reading, I'll be like thinking about my story in the background, and just the act of reading will make me want to write. Also, sometimes I'll watch my favorite TV shows like Grimm or Once Upon a Time, and I'll watch them and I'll see how they build their worlds or their characters, and I'll be like, ooh, that's really cool. And then I'll start thinking about if I can implement something similar to that in my story, if that's the kind of thing that would work in my world. Write peeve. What's one thing writers do or you do that's annoying? Oh, I feel like I had an answer to this at one point in time. This is kind of a really superficial answer. So when I was in college, I was a creative writing minor, and I took 6 creative writing classes altogether. And, you know, you workshop people's work, so they'll pass it out, you'll read it, and then you'll talk about it the next class, and you'll mark it up, and you'll type out a letter to them, telling them what you thought and stuff. And so in marking up the draft, one of the things that always annoyed me, which not every writer did it, but some did, the misuse of M dashes, N dashes, and hyphens. People would interchange them. They'll put a hyphen where there's supposed to be an M dash, or they'll put an N dash, or they won't put an M dash when there should be an M dash there. And I'm just like, this is not how you use them. I have a lot of editing experience, so I'm just like, whenever I see, you know, grammar mistakes, like I'm not aware of every single grammar mistake, but you know, M dashes, N dashes, and hyphens, because like, I know their applications very well, I get really annoyed when I see them used wrongly, which like I don't blame the writers necessarily for using them wrong, because I will use things wrong. It's totally fine. It's just, you know, when I see it, I'm like, it's really stupid. It doesn't matter, especially if it's just a draft, and it's the kind of thing that you look at in line editing. But you know, that's one thing, like as I've grown as a writer, I've had to pay less attention to things like grammar and line edits, and have to, at least initially, and we'll have to focus first on big picture edits, you know, developmental things. So yeah, it doesn't bother me like as much now, I don't think, but when I was like seeing them, but you know, there's still that initial reaction when you see something like that, you're like, I want to correct this. And the last one, write words, share something you've written. So I've never really shared my writing outside of a creative writing class. Yeah, so this will be really interesting. Let me find it. This is from something that I wrote like 3 days ago, so it hasn't been edited yet. It's completely different from my normal writing style because I wanted to try something new, but this is from a story that I've just started. I don't think I'm gonna give it any context either. We'll see if it even makes sense without it, but yeah. Vivian is a snake shedding the tote from her arm like an old skin. The jacket would come next, but she won't be here long enough to heat popcorn. The contents within the tote rattle and clink, shimmy and shake. She almost has to cover her eyes because she can't handle the beauty of her treasure. Dreyas's greedy eyes hide from view as he leans and eclipses her light. She resists pushing his head out of the way. Gloves come off, flop on table. Breathing is loud. The air reeks of chemicals. Powders dust the tables and counters. There's a madman before her and he's reaching into the tote. Yeah. I didn't say what was in the tote. It's bones. There are bones inside of her tote. Yeah. That's all I'm going to tell you about that story. Anyway, this was the Writer Life Tag. I hope you really enjoyed it. Down in the comments, I would like to know what is your biggest writing pet peeve. Thank you guys so much for watching. Give this video a like, hit subscribe, and I will see you in the next one. Bye!